Hi, welcome to the channel. My name's DC Breaks, and in this video, I'm going to be exploring another AI mixing tool, this time courtesy of Unchained Music. I'm going to be exploring their RoEx Studio online platform, which is an AI mixing and mastering tool, and seeing how well it can mix a track. So this is the Unchained Music website. As you can see, the service is currently in an open beta phase, and what it promises is that AI mixing and mastering is finally here. We can use the Unchained Music RoEx Mixing Studio, which we'll look at in a minute, to have our track professionally mixed and mastered in just a matter of minutes, and all for a fraction of the cost of using legacy services. In other words, hiring a human mixing or mastering engineer so that we can focus on what matters most, making music. So quite grandiose claims. Let's see if it can actually live up to some of those claims. So if you saw my previous video on AI mixing, I was using Neutron 4 and some of the AI functionality within that to help mix this track, which is a recording of Sarah Elizabeth Charles. And what I've done is I've just run off stems of each of the main groups. So I've got our backing vocals, bass, drums, guitar, keys, and lead vocals. And then without doing anything else, I've just run off a mix, an unmixed mix, if you like, that we can use as a reference to compare against the version that Unchained is hopefully going to give us. So to use the service, you just create an account, log in, you can try it for free, hit mix your music, and that'll open up the Unchained RoEx Mixing Studio. It's very intuitive and easy to use. You just upload your audio files. I've just added mine already to save time here. Choose your musical style. There's 7 or 8 here to choose from. I've gone with rock slash indie for this, although presumably choosing pop or acoustic will give a different result. And then it's just a case of assigning each of your stems an instrument group. So backing vocals are, of course, vocals. You can select the importance in terms of how high it is in the mix. So these are backing vocals, so their importance is medium. I could perhaps choose low as well. You can choose a pan preference, so left, center, or right, and the amount of reverb, which, as it says, can work well on vocals and drums. So it's just a case then of going through and choosing the different settings that you want. So that requires, I guess, a small amount of mixing knowledge. For example, obviously you want your bass panned in the center. You probably want your drums panned to the center as well, but I guess that's, you know, that is optional. And then choosing the according amount of, you know, reverb and things like that, and how important each part is. So for example, the vocal, I've given the highest importance and pan that to the center and given that a bit more reverb. So once you've done that, you can then hit this little rocket logo, and that will create a brand new mix. So let's give it a go. So from here, we can choose whether we're creating a stem mix or a master. Let's just go for a stem mix to start with. And then we hit our little rocket, and it's going to go and mix it for us. So it took 4 or 5 minutes for the AI to mix the track for us. I can now listen to this. I can then also come back and change some of the mix settings and create another mix if I want to, if there's things I don't like. But the problem is, if that's going to take 5 minutes every single time, that's quite a fiddly process. So let's say if I listened through and decided actually I wanted a bit more reverb or less importance on the backing vocal, for example, you know, that's potentially, you know, 5 minutes every time I want to monitor one of these changes. But that aside, let's put this back into Logic now and see how it sounds. Okay, so I've brought the mix from Unchained back into Logic, and I've been able to compare it with the reference unmixed mix, which, if you recall, was just a sum of the individual stems without any processing applied whatsoever. And having spent a bit of time to listen through and compare the two, I think there's some processing that's been applied that might be beneficial for the track in some areas, and in some areas it's still not quite right. So the mix that it's delivered, I don't think, is quite up to professional standards yet. So let's listen to the tone first of all. You'll notice that it's quite a lot brighter than the reference mix. Do you wanna be my baby? 'Cause this could be more than just a one night ride, baby. You've got my heart acting crazy, baby. And you might also pick up that there's some reverb that's been added as was requested, and also the stereo image is a bit wider. So the overall effect is that the mix is brighter, wider, and a bit more spacious sounding, and I think that's definitely enhanced the reference mix to an extent, but I think perhaps the tone overall is a bit too bright and it would actually benefit from a little bit more in the low end. But there's more fundamental problems than that. Hey guys, I hope you're enjoying the content. Just to let you know that we offer online courses in a range of creative subjects. So if you're interested in taking your skills and knowledge to the next level, check out the link below. One thing it hasn't been able to do very effectively at all is to handle things like the variation in the backing vocals. So for example, we can see here that the backing vocal is quite varied in level. And it's not just because the vocalist is in singing the chorus and is adding more emphasis. It really is just a case of the vocalist being a bit too close to the microphone here and here, and that sounds quite different.
Slow down, baby. Slow down.
So a human mixing engineer might decide to fix that with some manual compression or volume automation, or compression or EQ, or you know, a number of different things. The AI has attempted, or through its processing, it has perhaps inadvertently fixed that to an extent, but it doesn't sound quite right still. So let's have a listen.
Say goodbye.
Slow down, baby.
If you just
slow down.
So you can hear that slowdown is much louder than that one. And you might also pick up, it sounds as though it is being compressed with perhaps quite a slow attack. So some of the initial phrases coming through and then the compressor is pulling it back down. I'm not sure if that's been applied to that individual stem or to a bus or a group or however it's doing it. But the result, the end result, still isn't quite right. Have another listen.
Baby, don't say goodbye.
Slow down, baby.
If you just
slow down.
And the problem we've got with using a service like this, such that it is at the moment, is that there's no real recourse to kind of go in and fix something like that. The only controls that we have are these importance controls, so we could bring the whole stem up in the mix. We could add more reverb and change the pan preference, but that's not going to deal with this type of problem. And even if we did, you know, we're going to have to sit there for another 5 minutes, then review that change, and you know, it's not a very quick process. And for something relatively straightforward, you know, it says that they're doing this because, you know, people can't be bothered, or they, you know, they find it difficult or time consuming to do mixing. But you know, that is not a particularly challenging thing to do, is just to change the level between different parts of a stem. So whilst I think the technology is really interesting, and obviously it's in its infancy, it's still not quite at the point yet where it can compete with a human, although I should say that, you know, it's a lot cheaper. So, you know, a mixing engineer, depending on their experience, could be quite an expensive option for a band. For some musicians, that might not be a feasible option. But using RoEx, you know, for very little money, you can get a couple of download credits per month. And that might be enough to get your mix better than what you're able to do yourself. So I hope you found that interesting. Let me know what you think in the comments below, and don't forget to hit like and subscribe as well. And stay tuned, because I'm going to be continuing this exploration into AI mixing tools in the next video, where I'm going to take a look at another platform called CryoMix.